I'm ready for more. Tell them I'm ready for more. I'm ready for war. Tell them I'm ready for war.
Taking it about the one. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The Dolphins ready to go to work on offense, led by their second-year quarterback out of Alabama. It's Tua Tagovailoa.
And this is a game for grit, determination, and somehow finding a way not to panic. What a horrible start for them. I mean, they haven't won a game yet. So now, as a quarterback, you're not just talking to your team. You got to demonstrate to them what they need to do to win. He's got to be the leader by how he plays.
A big play there for the Dolphins. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. From the gun, it's Tua. And this one complete to Will Fuller. And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. Tua sets up to pass it. That's complete to his tight end, Mike Gesicki. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars' 24-yard line. Time with Devontae Freeman. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about four. Second and six. The numbers for Freeman a week ago. 17 carries, 56 yards.
They've lost a bunch of games in a row now. They've got to start thinking a little bit differently, maybe a little bit outside of the box. Find other ways to move the football. I don't know if you're going to do it through the air or maybe change up how you establish your run game.
That's a very nice game there, a confidence-building run. Love the execution up front, and the way he pressed the hole, absolutely perfect.
Tua now on first down. Over the middle and complete to Waddle. They'll contain him to just four, second down. Here's Tagovailoa to throw. Dancing to his left. And just shy of the goal line as he's out of bounds right at the one.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his second read wasn't there. But he bought himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket. Got to the...
And they're going to get to him. A sack. Sack back at the 9-yard line. Josh Allen. The blitz works to perfection as he gets in there to dump him for a loss of 8. Now from the 9, here's second and goal. Out of the gun, they give to Freeman. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. It'll go as no gain on the play, and now they're looking at a third and goal. Driven it down the field nicely here on the opening drive, and now it's put up or shut up.
No doubt about it, because to make that type of a drive and ultimately kick a field goal would feel very disappointing. But I'm just...
Touchdown, Dolphins! Devontae Parker, his second touchdown on the season. And the Dolphins take it right down and score on the opening drive. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And that makes the score 7-0. A 10-play drive that time. And it ends with a touchdown for the Dolphins. And no return here for Agnew, so they'll bring it out, start the drive at the 25. For the first time, the Jacksonville Jaguars set to go here on offense, led out by the new face of the franchise, the number one overall pick, of course, from this year's draft. It's Trevor Lawrence out of Clemson. Here's Lawrence. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Eric Rowe. And they will finally run him down, but not until he brings this one all the way back down inside the 10-yard line. Suddenly, it's first and goal after the interception. A quick change in the situation here. Over the middle, he's got Gesicki, the big 6'5 tight end. A gain of 7 that time. Second and goal. He'll run here with Carter. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Dolphins touchdown. Stephen Carter, his first touchdown on the year. And the Dolphins are off to a 13-0 first quarter lead. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And it's now 14-0. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. Now Jamal Agnew from his end zone. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling, because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give him a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down. Now they face a third down and 4 after that incompletion on second down. He'll fight his man, Laviska Shenault. And he is finally out of bounds, but not before taking it down inside the 30. A big third down play there for the Jags.
On third down, it's very simple. Make sure you get beyond the sticks, make the catch, pick up the first down. But in this case, he turned it into bonus time and was off to the races for a monster play.
And he'll go down right on the edge of the red zone following a pickup of about 7 or 8. Second and 2. Handoff running left is ETN, and he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line.
Not too many more ideal situations at second and 2 in order to try and pick up a first down. They ran it and picked it up.
On first and 10, it's Lawrence. And he slings one that's incomplete.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
On second down, a run with ETN. And he's able to get this inside the 10 now to the 9. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3. Now Lawrence to throw. And this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on third down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to. The offense is not leaving the field. They're going to stay out and go for it on 4th and 3. Now, meanwhile, they go for it on 4th down, and my goodness, incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it, and the Dolphins defense is able to hold. protection. Now it's Tua. Open receiver here. Complete. It's Parker. And he takes this just about a yard shy of the 20. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Tagovailoa working out of the gun. And they're able to get this one across the 35. So Tua making the completion there. What's different about playing a left-handed quarterback like him? And specifically, I guess, what does this defense need to try and take away?
I'll take the first part that you asked about being left-handed. We've got to find out if he can move to his right and still continue to be accurate. So I want to push him in that direction and see if he can get his body squared around and make those throws that he's used to making. The next part is he's a dart thrower. Loves those short to intermediate routes first. Sit on those and make him throw the deep ball. Not that he's not capable, but you want him to prove it to you first.
And he's down right around midfield after a gain of 2, maybe 3. 3 yards the gain there, second down. Nothing to score. This is the NFL on EA Sports. From midfield, here's Tua. He'll get this to his tight end, Gesicki. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down. Tua to throw again. This one complete to Devontae Freeman. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars' 27-yard line.
But things are definitely going right for them here in the first half. Pick a down, any down, even third down, no problem. They get a connection there and pick up a fresh set of downs, continuing to move the ball.
Meanwhile, Tua's throw here taken in by Parker. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. They'll run here with Freeman. And he takes it into the end zone for the Dolphin touchdown. Devontae Freeman, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Dolphins go coast to coast and finish the drive off with 6 points. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And it's now 21-0. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. To return, here's Agnew. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. They had a great drive going last time. They were moving the ball, and then all of a sudden it just stalled out. So we'll see what they can do here, Charles.
And it's always easy to second guess when you don't get it on a fourth down try. But they had to like the feeling that they had going on offense. They want to continue to see if they can capture that again on this drive and maybe get in the same position.
Yeah, and that's, I mean, like I said, they were moving the football. It's not like they went four and out, so I don't think it's a deal where the offense doesn't have confidence.
No, I agree with you totally on that one. If anything, they may have gained more confidence. Okay, they stopped us once. That's all right. Let's keep moving it. Make them do it again.
The Dolphins get there this time, and they...
time yet. They are not getting much generated offensively. They've got to figure it out.
It's tough because this defense just seems to be playing with so much confidence right now.
They really are. They are on their toes, and they're getting at them.
So possession goes over here on the punt, and it'll be Dolphin football. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. The ledger for them so far looks pretty good, doesn't it?
It certainly does. Touchdown, touchdown, touchdown. Not sure it can be much better than that. They've got to feel very good about the groove that they're in at this stage of the game.
To throw on second and six, Tua. And he's got his big tight end here. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. Setting to throw on first down is Tua. It's complete to Fuller. And now we'll get a timeout. Looks like we've got a Jaguar in some discomfort down there on the field. Second and 10. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break. On second down, Freeman. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11. Looking to pass. Tua. Tua hit, and the ball is out. And the Jags grab it. And he'll take it across midfield and down the 48-yard line. Obviously, you got to hold on to the football, but I've got to give credit to the defense there. Good job of knocking it free.
Yeah, because a lot of the time we just blame the offensive players for not taking care of it. How about the effort of the defensive players knowing that guys are going to, and if they're good, anticipate the contact coming and try and cover up the football. And they still find ways to knock it free.
And now the throw taken in by Chark. Touchdown, Jaguars! DJ Chark, his second touchdown on the season. And the Jaguars make some inroads here on that deficit. Extra point splits the uprights, and the lead will be cut down to 14. The long touchdown pass gets him six on a very, very tidy two-play drive that time. Igbinoghene elects not to return it. The football will come out to the 25-yard line. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And last time, not only the turnover, but that turned into 6 points. They got to make up for that here.
We always hear about empty possessions, but some are worse than others. You can have an empty possession, pump the ball away, get yourself set to play defense, but when you turn it over, it changes momentum, and when they take it downfield and punch it in on you, that's a bad possession all the way around.
Yeah, but you're hungry to get back out there, aren't you?
You better be, because otherwise, it's going to be a long day for you.
The Dolphins on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This will be third and 5. Throwing now is Tagovailoa. Throw left side here, complete to the tight end, Gesicki. And he'll be out of bounds, just shy of the 40. A big play there on the catch and run.
And I feel a little bit like a traitor as a former defender, because that big man did not want to go down and refused to go down. If you're a defender and you don't get the right angle on a big tight end like him, he can run right through you like you're not even there, and he did a lot of that on that play.
A good run, got 7 on first. Here's 2nd and 3. Here's Tua. Now a short one to Gesicki.
We saw this jumping jack make steady improvement his first 3 years in Miami, and he topped it off at 53 catches last year, career high. Now in his fourth season, I expect his numbers to continue to rise.
And the result here, a pickup of 8, leaves him with 2 to go on 2nd down. From the 22, Tua. And that is incomplete. And Charles, you wonder about this defense coming in. I mean, look, it's no secret they're playing a team that's down on its luck right now. Losers of five straight. How does that change how you prepare for a game?
Well, to me, the first thought is you just get after them early, right? Take away any chance of them building any confidence. But the second thing is you prepare a little bit differently. You've got to expect this team to take chances, go for it on third and fourth downs, run a lot of trick plays, anything to try and break their losing streak. So you must stay alert and stay aware.
Here's Tagovailoa on first and 10. And a nice job to break free of one tackle, but it slowed his momentum somewhat, and he's taken down right after. Ball at the 14 for second and 5. Going to the air, Tagovailoa. To a hit, and the ball is out. And the Jags grab it. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Always costly to cough up that football. These defenders, they become so adept, though, at jarring it free.
Yeah, it's amazing that there aren't more fumbles caused, because now, if you're an offensive player, you go through ball security drills every single day. It's really not out of line to think that you should take the ball to bed with you and just hold on to it. But the bottom line is, no matter how much you try to protect it, these guys are pretty.
Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. The Jaguars going to go ahead and use their first timeout, as they'll stop it with exactly a minute to go before halftime. Second and 21, a lot of ground to cover. Another try after the first down sack. Lawrence finding room at the 30 and all the way up to the 37-yard line. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. And this pass broken up. The contact well timed there, and now fourth down. Here's Logan Cook now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. His first punt, 48 yards. This one looks equally as good. Now we'll see what the big tight end, Mike Gesicki, and the rest of the offense has in store. The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. And with a two-score lead already, they may just look to get this thing to the locker room. Two and now on first down. Over the middle, and it's incomplete.
A lot of times, just that first read that you had, maybe you get it in pre-snap, and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
To throw once more on second and 10. Tua on the move to his left, shedding the tackle, and out of bounds across the 15-yard line. He'll wind up with positive yardage. It's a gain of 3, but now it's third down. This time they stay on the ground, and he'll only get this to the 17, well shy of what he needed. Just a 1-yard gain on the play, and that'll mean a call to the punt team as it's fourth down. And okay, so much for our halftime break. Apparently we're going to get right back to it. As they say here in London, all to play for as we are back underway in the second half. And they'll bring it out to the 25 as Agnew elects for the touchback. The Jaguars ready to get going to start quarter number 3. And they're on the short end of the scoreboard here. Charles, what adjustments, if any, do you think they need to make for the second half?
Well, paraphrasing the gold medal hockey winning coach Herb Brooks, I just say you continue to play your game. Throw the ball. They had success doing it in the first half. So make sure you keep getting the ball to your playmakers, a little bit more to the perimeter perhaps. But above all, play your game.
Second and 6, just inside the 30. They'll go again with ETN. Not much room here as he only gets it to about the 30. Call it a gain of a yard, and it's going to bring up 3rd and 5.
And this is why aggressive defense coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D lineman to make the play.
Back, 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 back. Lawrence will throw. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game, because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45. Another 13 yards there twice in a row, and they're on the move. Another first down as well. From the gun, it's Lawrence. Flush to his right. And the Dolphins' rush gets home. Down he goes. It'll be a loss of 7 on the sack, and it brings up second. Lawrence, now this is ETN on the draw. And that didn't fool anybody. He's going to be dropped in the backfield. They lose 2 on that last play, so things get even tougher. 3rd and long coming up. Looking to throw, Lawrence. He'll get this out to the flat for ETN. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. You thought you had the defensive stand. Roughing the passer wipes it out.
What does every defense talk about? 3 and out, right? Thought they were able to get off the field. Not so.
And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole. The scoreboard tells a story for them, a little bit bleak, and while it's not quite desperation time yet, it's definitely getting close, but the defense reads the scoreboard as well. They're going to back up and make them really earn it.
Jones has it. And he will have a Jaguars first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
And partner, they're locked in man coverage out left, and they end up running a crossing route. Rounded it a little bit more than a slant. And he's just going to angle himself towards the right side of the field, and that's very difficult for a defender to shadow him across all that ground.
A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's 2nd down. Now Lawrence steps away to his left. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable. And that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that. And they force another incompletion.
And able to get this down inside the 15, either the 13 or 14 before he's out of bounds. They pick up 10, but it'll still lead to a 4th down. And they'll try and throw forward with Lawrence. McKinner here, it's complete. And the Jags are going to have 1st and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. 1st and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. And he'll run with ETN. Now we've got whistles, and the man slow to get up here is Jones. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. Good yardage on 1st down. Now can they punch it in on 2nd and goal? Once more, ETN. And he is not going to get in as the big bodies stop him at the 1. They hold him again, and now all of a sudden it's 3rd and goal at the 1.
Sometimes I get caught in hyperbole, but I think they desperately need to punch this one in. They're running out of time.
Yeah, 2-score game, 2nd half, you're down here. This is the time to put it in the end zone.
And not going to get much better than this for an opportunity.
And good pressure defensively to stop him for a loss of a couple. Now there's also a flag to go with it. That's Juwan Taylor, the right tackle. The holding penalty, that puts him in an unenviable spot here as they try again on third and goal. Here's Lawrence to throw. Hit as he throws there, incomplete. The Dolphins do the job defensively there, and now it brings up fourth. And this one is right through. And that will get the disadvantage now back down to 11. So a good drive there to begin quarter number three, but they're only able to shave 3 points off the lead.
Well, something's better than nothing, all right? They didn't play particularly well in the first half, but they definitely need them to step on the accelerator now and play a whole lot better.
Taking it about the one. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. They've got to right the ship. They had a great first half, but the lead has really gone down. Now, you know, you always talk about the adjustment to the adjustment. They've got to adjust right here.
And I think a lot of it is just mentally. Get back to doing what you were doing well in the beginning of the game, but a lot of that is playing with that emotion and that sense of pride and fire that sometimes goes away a little bit when you build up a lead. You think you've got it going, and you also think, at any moment, I can go ahead and go back to the way it was before. You and I both know it's not that easy once you get off the gas a little.
Yeah, they don't want to see this lead diminish anymore.
Hunter Long, the Dolphins' third-round pick out of Boston College, was selected to pair with Mike Gesicki to give defenses matchup problems when they try and cover both of these tight ends. On that play, Long gets open and picks up a first down. Miami's receivers had the second fewest yards of any receiving group in 2020 and the fewest yards in run after catch as well. Jaylen Waddle, he might solve both of those problems. Taking sixth overall, he picks up the first down.
To a hit and the ball is out. But this will get out of bounds, so possession will stay the same. Looking at it from the defense's perspective, they could have really used the football to try to start eating into this deficit.
Yeah, because now possession's so crucial at this stage of the game. And when you've got an opportunity to hop on a turnover and you don't get it, you can feel the frustration all the way up here.
And the offense, they're living right now. Another bounce and break that goes their way. 56 yards rushing for him now in the ball game. On the heels of that good carry by Devontae Freeman, here's first and 10. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. Oh, not sure he saw the linebacker there as that's batted down and incomplete. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Now Tua. And this is Parker, complete. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we play three quarters. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Third and one, and Tua wants to throw it. And able to find Gesicki as tight end. But he has the first down before he's tackled at the five. A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is first and goal. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the one. Give him four on the carry there and second and goal. Tua going to throw. And that is caught. Touchdown, Miami. Adam Shaheen, his first touchdown on the year. And the Dolphins add on to their lead, and they appear poised to break this long losing streak. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And the lead is up to 18 now. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. To return, here's Agnew. Now a crease here as he's past the 30. And a good return, able to get out across the 35 to the 36. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And just looking ahead, it would appear that that bye week is coming at the right time. They'll have 2 weeks to chew on this one, though probably not one that they want to chew on. A poor performance from start to finish. Well, the trials and tribulations of being a quarterback in this league, it's tough. It's got to be wearing on him out there.
Well, he has been sacked a number of times. He had an interception, so I'm going to give him a skosh of credit for hanging in there and trying to make something happen, despite the amount of pressure he's been under this entire game.
And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. That'll leave him with a third and two coming up. They got 8 yards there. Now Lawrence. All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off by Eric Rowe. And a super return as he gets us all the way down inside the 25-yard line. Defensively that time, they were in zone coverage. As a rookie QB, what lesson can you learn there?
Well, understand this. You saw zone in college, and the defensive backs reacted, but they don't react like they do on this level. So when they're in zone and they see the ball coming to them, they'll react at least a half a second faster. You've got to know where you want to go with the ball and be decisive with it. Otherwise, the end result can be something you don't like.
On second and nine, Tua. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. We'll check on his status when we get back. They fake the handoff. Now Tua. And oh, it'll be intercepted. It's C.J. Henderson picking it off. And the Jags are going to take over here on the INT at their own 5-yard line. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And you hate to see this for them, but they're looking at yet another loss to begin this season. Things really going from bad to worse as they trail here starting this drive, first and 10 in the fourth quarter.
Well, I can put my defensive cap on right now, and I know they're saying don't give up any big plays now. They've controlled this game throughout, and all they want to do is see it through to the end. I think they let their guard down a little bit with that last completion. Sometimes when you're trying not to give up bigger plays, you don't react as fast as you should on other throws.
Looking to throw again on second down. Lawrence, this is Chenault on the receiving end. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. And he's been one of their few bright spots here this afternoon.
And as you pointed out, so far he's gotten his. That's not been the issue at all. But the teammates, the other guys, they've been shut.
The Dolphins get there this time, and they bring him down. It'll be a loss of 7 on the sack, and it brings up second. Another try after the first down sack. Lawrence caught by Jones. The reception good for 7. It's third down. Lawrence.
Completion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration, the body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
They're going on fourth down. Lawrence firing quickly here, and that's complete. And unable to break away, they stop him a few yards shy. The Jags come up empty on fourth down, and it'll be a turnover on downs. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. The drive will start with a carry by Devontae Freeman. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down. Again, they'll run with Freeman. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to third down. Drop to throw. Throwing to Parker, complete on the slant. And he is going to have the Dolphins first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Now Freeman, he's been busy today. And he'll go down at the 26, following a gain of 6. 6 yards on that last play. Here's second and 4. Freeman again. And this time not as successful, as he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. Call it no gain that time, as it's going to leave him with a third and about 3 to go. So the Dolphins have it as we welcome you back in. They've got a third down now as they look for one more first down to help salt this one away. And down inside the 15 he goes. 85 yards for him on the ground now on 18 carries.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it.
And he will take it in for a Dolphins touchdown. Devontae Freeman with his second touchdown of the game and 5th on the year. And the Dolphins add on to their lead. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And they open the lead up now to 25. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. To return, here's Agnew. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Travis Etienne of the Jags offense set to take over again here. So after that hot start, the numbers here show the decline. What has the defense done adjustment-wise?
Sometimes when you have a running back who's gotten off to a hot start, you've got to catch him before he really gets going. So you change what you do across the defensive front. Instead of the linebackers being back a few yards, you bring them up closer. It's what we call mugging the line of scrimmage, taking away a lot of blocking angles and gaps, and maybe stopping him before he can get going.
Mugging the line of scrimmage, okay.
Yeah, in this case.
They'll get this off DTN. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. Call that a loss of a yard, and things get a little more difficult here. 3rd and 5. From the shotgun, Lawrence. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off near the 34. And the return will stop right around the 25. The disaster there, I mean, you saw it coming. The pressure gets knocked down, the interception.
Sometimes the best throw you make is the one you
don't make.
Exactly. Take care of the football. He'll also learn how to shrug his shoulders, take the proper slide steps to alleviate some of the pressure. But occasionally, like the one we just saw, sometimes just hold on to the football and take the hit.
So a victory here for the Miami Dolphins.